This is a quick review of an inexpensive end-fed half-wave or EFHW antenna that I built using a 49:1 transformer that I bought off of Amazon for $25 and 100 foot of 18 gauge wire that I bought from a local electronics store for $22. This is the screen from Amazon showing the end-fed half-wave 49:1 transformer at a very reasonable price. And we see some scuff marks that were not present, as we'll see in the product that I received. So the one that I got was actually better looking than this one. I did not get this sticker on mine. And slight differences there about the layout of this box, but pretty much the same as we will see. Very solid construction, as we will see. But the one thing to notice is that this is a strange make. And then there's other ones similar to this one in Amazon that have other strange make names. But the prices are ranging from $20 to $25. So I figured I would try it to see how this turned out. And we'll see how it did. This is the package that came in for the end-fed half-wave antenna. So, first of all, comes in this nice package. The construction of this thing, it's pretty solid. It seems to be good construction. So now let's go ahead and open it up, see what the construction inside is all about. Okay. So first thing to notice is that there's no seal around here, no plastic seal, but it does have a lip that fits into here. So it gives a good seal there. And the construction is fine. I don't see any cold solder joints. This soldering right here seems to be pretty well made. A little bit of bubbling there, but not anything bad. The components are well fit in there. Another good solder joint over here. The toroid doesn't look bad. I mean, the toroid looks of decent construction. There's a little bit of silicone right there that we can just get rid of. But that's it. I don't see any rubbing or anything like that in the pieces. So the only thing is, I saw something wiggling around. Yeah, this right here was a little bit of a solder ball that was loose inside. But that's it. Just take that out. And for the price, this seems to be a very good assembly. So let's see how it works out in the field. So this is the end-fed half-wave antenna. I've connected it up to 100 foot of line, 18 gauge line. This is the wire that I used out back. It's 100 foot, it's NTE electronics. And this one was the yellow one. Of course, it's all used up because I used 100 feet. But this is the black one that I've used on another project. So it says 18 gauge wire. It works pretty good for antennas. So this is what I've used. And I've got 65 feet of line going directly up to a fiberglass pole up here, right up there. I don't know if you can tell, but it's up there in the trees, leaning against there. You can see the base of it right there, and it connects up there. And again, the rest of the line is coming down here. So it's an inverted L, essentially, 65 feet in a sloper. And then this cable right here, which is the remnant of the 100 foot line. So once we have that, this is going into the station here. With our G8X cable. And right here, we're getting the station. And I'm powering it up with 3.7 volt batteries, 2600, the 18650s there. So powering up the G90.
Thanks for stopping. happen in Ocean X or Ocean F1.
And the tuning. Is pretty darn close to 1-to-1 on 20 meters. If I change to 17 meters, make sure the tuner's off, and tuning it right there, again, pretty darn close to 1-to-1 on 17 meters.
Well, I think the folks in Buffalo might have that inclination.
Make sure the tuner is off. And right there, on 15 meters, from 200 to 300 there, it's, you know, below one, about 1.4 to 1.
Looks up for anything like that. Where in Nebraska are you?
If I go to the lower end of the band, it's again 1.45, 1.4, 1.5 to 1. So pretty much tuning across the. Actually, I just noticed something real quick. Yeah, it seems to go up and down a little bit as far as the tuning. So it stabilized at 1.4, but then it started going down a little bit lower. Yeah, maybe by touching it, that drops the tuning down. And on 12 meters. Again, tuning pretty well. 1.5 to 1. And this is a 10 meter band. A little bit high there, you know, the CW part of the spectrum. And if we go up a little bit higher there, still about 2-to-1. The tuner for the G90 will get it taken care of, no problem. The problem band, well, not the 30 meter, even the 30 meter band was working okay. Make sure the tuner is off and try it again. And again, the 30 meter band is tuning very nicely. And if we go down to the 40 meter band without the tuner, this is a bit of a problem. It's a little bit high. So something like the 7300 would not be able to bring that down, but the G90 does. And now we do. And there you go. So with a tuner, then is the 40 meter band requires a tuner. And if I go a little bit higher on the band, again, it's beyond 4-to-1. So it requires a tuner on the 40 meter band. The 80 meter band also requires a tuner. But curiously enough, the 160 meter band doesn't require a tuner. It's working, it's coming in fine.
In the Revolutionary War, just check us out on QRZ.com, okay?
Yeah, Roger Dad. Yeah, I got the QSL cards from last year. Gonna do it again this year. Thanks for the special event. Have fun.
So the antenna is working out pretty well. Again, it's a very inexpensive antenna. And the cable was $22 at a local electronics store here. And it's just 18 gauge wire. And it's configured in a sloper configuration with a fiberglass pole holding it up, following the lead of Mike K8MRD, who did something similar. So that seems to be doing the trick. I didn't go ahead and cut the line at 65 feet like I thought I was going to have to. Instead, I've just let it dangle down to make it more like a sort of like an inverted L, if you will. And that seems to be doing the trick. Again, signals are coming in very nicely.
Thank you.
looking to be a great day. We didn't even have a really cold morning. It was 33 when I woke up. And
so it seems to be working very well.